Well, one of the ways that weeds spread, invasive plants spread, is through human vectors, like walkers, mountain bikers, and things like that. So we're asking walkers about their boot cleaning practices. So we're interested in how they clean their boots, if they clean their boots, what they think about that. It can be something a little bit tricky sometimes to talk to them because it's obviously not something people necessarily think about a lot.
We're asking bushwalkers some questions about their current attitudes towards boot cleaning, whether they already know about the importance of cleaning off dirt and vegetation from their boots to prevent the spread of weeds.
So the weed we're particularly interested in, hawkweed species. There's orange hawkweed, mouse-eared hawkweed, and these are daisy-like plants. And there are small populations in the park. They're not very well established yet, and the park service still thinks they have a chance of eradicating those plants. That's the key issue that we're interested in, and one of the potential vectors is walkers.
So I think we're interested in how people interact with the environment, and you kind of only really understand that by talking to them. So coming up here, talking to the hikers, intercepting them before or after they walk, and really getting to know, yeah, like sort of how their practices of cleaning boots, or if they're aware of that and how that impacts the environment.
So one of the things that human geographers are interested in is people's attitudes and relationships to the environment. So, and one of the things that we've been interested in at Wollongong is a range of how people make decisions and behave around environmental issues. So we are what you might call environmental social scientists.
I think that this project is really interesting for me as a human geographer because it is sort of an intersect between social and environmental issues. So it's looking at how we can solve a problem of environmental issues through implementing sort of social infrastructure so that people who are bushwalking can clean their boots and reduce their impact of spreading these weeds that can be particularly harmful in pristine areas like Kosciuszko.
So I think the main thing that attracted me to it was because it was an awesome opportunity to actually come up with an academic and sort of shadow or experience what it is like to do research in the field.
I love field work. I'm a bit of a field work junkie. And one of the great things about geography, and one of the things that really attracted me personally to it, was that opportunity to get out into places like this.
Yeah, well, I think human geography is really cool because it really does look at the big picture issues of how the world works. Then we also sort of get down to these individual issues, like specifically orange hawkweed in Kosciuszko National Park.